Good evening, good evening. Good evening, everyone. I hope you're well. It's a Thursday night, and I'm doing something a little bit different tonight. I'm going to be doing some sampling, strictly sampling. So I kind of see this as a two-part session. I'm going to spend this evening just sampling a bunch of vinyl. With a view to then kind of putting it all together on Sunday, the Ski Sunday session, into a track. And I was also thinking of kind of extending this out actually by providing these samples, the samples that I get tonight. And for the subbers, I've now got a sub channel on my Discord, which is great. So I can kind of make it available on Discord. Maybe I'll make it available to everyone actually. And yeah, maybe you guys can have a go at putting something together as well. I really don't know what I'm going to get out of this at all. I've got a bunch of records. Now, the theme tonight is strictly Japanese music. I have been to Japan many times, and when I go there, I always tend to pick up some vinyl. It's one of my favorite things to do. And I've got quite a few, and some of them, they just kind of sit in the rack. Don't see much light of day, so it's kind of a good opportunity to actually trawl through them and see if I can get some little gems. Hey, yes, Music On, how you doing? Nice to see you here. Brilliant, nice to have you along. Always glad to know that this is actually working. Twitch is working, it's always a good thing. So yeah, I've got a bit of intricate setting in my little studio. I've got my iPhone pointing down onto the deck. Obviously got the camera from my Mac, and I've also got the camera going down on the push as well. So yeah, I think we should just get going. Cool. So what have we got first? What I'm going to do, I can actually switch here. So it's just going to close. So I've got two monitors, and I've just got a bunch of windows open. So I need to can I make this as efficient as possible? Okay, cool. So there's that. Got the chat there, got that there. Right, so first up, we've got this little gem. So this is an album. It's called Ultra Q Synthesizer Fantasy. And I remember when I was in Banana Records in Nagoya, I just couldn't resist this. I just thought, well, that just looks so cool. Goodness knows what's on it. Let's open it up and have a little listen. I think what I'm going to do is I've got Ableton, so I'm going to be recording it into Ableton. And I think when I hear something, I'll hit record, and then maybe we can do a bit of chopping up later, just to sort of mark out what the cool bits are. So let's get going. Here we go. Here's the first one. So. Ooh. Okay, well, that's already good, isn't it? There we go. So let's get going. Let's hit record. And hey, we don't want a metronome on, do we? No. In fact, let's just take the count in as that. Yeah, we don't want anything. There we go. Sounds like start a thriller or something, isn't it? Here we go. I forgot to show you Ableton. Okay, there's enough of that. Oh, there's a nice kick drum. Okay. Oh, sounds like a sort of sampled electric bass. Oh, what's that? It's quite fruitful, this one. Quite a few bits on this. Okay, quite enough of that. Okay. Okay, I think that's enough on that side. You never know what you're going to get. Sometimes it's only one tune on an album. Yeah, that same kind of sample bass sound. Not keen on that. Oh, that's nice. Okay. Does that help me? Bizarre. Cool, that's quite nice. I do like that synth sound. Okay, I think there's probably enough from that. So thank you very much, Ultra Q Synthesizer Fantasy. Very good. Let's just see who we got here. Please leave chat if you hear something cool, then let us know. Like I said, I'm going to be putting these onto Discord, these samples, so making them available. So maybe you can, as we're going through, you're going to hear some sounds, some things you like, and put something together. All right, so here we go. This is the next one. So this is it's a swap camera. So this is from the Sadistic Mika Band. There we go, it's called Black Ship. Now I'm pretty confident that this has got an amazing drum break on. So it's got the amazing Yukihiro Takahashi from Yellow Magic Orchestra, drummer of Yellow Magic Orchestra and amazing vocalist as well. He's on drums. So let's have a little listen to this. And see what we can find. Let's just go back on this. So here we go. Cool. YMO, yes. Big YMO fan. Oh yeah, I just thought I might show you my t-shirt. I'm not a big t-shirt wearer, but I thought I'd wear my 808 t-shirt, as I got this at Uniqlo, actually, a few years ago when I was in Japan. They were doing like a special promotion with Roland, so I got this one, and I got a 909 one as well. So okay, so let's have a listen to this, shall we? That's beautiful, isn't it? There's some lovely Fender Rhodes there. Let's capture that, definitely. In fact, let me just name these so we know what we're doing. That was Ultra Q? Yeah, Ultra Q. Okay. There we go. Need to have some kind of semblance of organization. There we go. We'll make that pink. And let's just open this up here. Nice. Okay, so let's capture a bit of this, shall we? Thanks, Funky On. It's a good t-shirt. I don't wear it that much, but I thought I'd make it wear it tonight, special occasion. I like that. Speeding up. Feels like it. Okay, enough of that. So much nice stuff on this. Ooh. Just want to capture that. Oops. Okay, that's a sample right there. Okay. Okay, nice. See if we can find this drum break. It's got to be there somewhere. You know what I should be doing? I should be cleaning my records before I play them. Care for your vinyl. Okay, here we go. Ooh. Got to get a bit of that. Okay, here we go. No. I want to go over what I've just recorded. Yes. Love it. Where's this drum break? What's the contender? It's gotta be this track. Find it. I know who's going to kill me for this. That's Sean Lee, because I remember him telling me about this. I'm going to quickly flip to the other side again, the first side, just to make sure I haven't missed it. Okay, maybe it's another record, you never know. But I think we've got some nice ones there. I'll have to have a look for that for another time. Hope everyone's all right. Thursday night, sampling session. You know what I'm gonna quickly do? So that was Sadistic Mika Band. Let me just name those. There we go, just select all. Command R. Sadistic Mika Band. Lovely. And let's give them a colour, shall we? What should we say? Let's give them a brown. Nice. So, what have we got? Let's just check these are coming out. Okay, actually, I think that's probably a good thing to do. So a sample, nice. And let's go back. Hey, let's see if I can remember how to pronounce it. Pixie Chaot, how you doing? How's it in Berlin? I've got some friends in Berlin. I've seen it's getting a bit warmer and a bit sunnier there. So yeah, hope you're cool. All right, I'm gonna put out one now. That I've just literally, it came in the post yesterday. It's released on the amazing label We Want Sounds. There we go. Let me show it to you. Cool. It's by Hiroshi Sato, Orient, and it's described as Hiroshi Sato's ultra-rare ambient funk masterpiece, originally released in 1979 in Japan on Kitty Records. Great. So glad I pronounced it well. So this is a gem. I mean, you just got to look at the cover. Is that a Poly Moog with a Mini Moog on top? And then he's just kind of, there's lots of him, sort of little mini Hiroshi Sato's kind of walking around on it. The back's pretty cool as well. But yeah, let's have a listen to that. Oops, whoa, just hit my iPhone. I think I need to get like a proper camera in here. Cool, right, so here we go. Let's see what's coming up here. All right, let's go back onto Ableton. Oh, it's a nice sound there, isn't there? Pretty nice. Nice kalimba. This is a brilliant album. Oh my god. Gotta get that. You know what I'm also gonna do is it's gonna take the global quantize. So the fixed grid, I'm going to take the fixed grid off because it just means I can just kind of click anywhere then. Quite good for this kind of thing. Right, let's grab these. These are beautiful. Okay. sounded pretty nice, didn't it? Yeah, just let everyone know as well, I've set up a sub-only channel now on my Discord, just kind of getting to grips with this Discord thing. So if anyone does kind of fancy signing up or subbing me, they'll get access to that channel. And basically, I plan to put all the kind of projects and samples and things that I work on every week on there. I just did the last one I did on Sunday was Bonnie and Clyde, the Matthew Herbert remix, and I've actually put that project up there. It's in Live 11, so I don't know how many people are actually on the Live 11 beta, but they're releasing it on February 23rd, the full Live 11 version. So if you haven't got it and you're going to be upgrading and you're using Ableton, of course, then you can access it. So it's on the Discord sub channel. So you'll probably see some links coming up in the chat if you want to join. So cool. Let's crack on with this. See if there's any more samples. Just that's quite nice, isn't it? It's like it's always pretty much at the start of every track there's some really cool sound. Okay, let's grab that. Just wondering actually if I can show. It'd be nice if I could on push if it would show the live recording. It must do that, surely. Maybe I need to click on it. If I do that, there you go, because it shows it there, but then doesn't seem to do it when I'm actually recording. Again. Too many good sounds. Okay, let's hit this. Let's go. Nice. That's a nice kick drum, isn't it? Nice bit of clavinet coming in there. Cool, that's that side. We're doing well. I think already just got so many samples. It's going to get to a point where there's going to be too many. But hey, you can never have too many samples. Similar to the last one. Nice. It's not Christmas though, is it? Oh, hang on. Hello. Funky Jungle. All right, this can definitely work. This is a nice little tom riff. Hey, Funky, on you've subscribed. Thanks so much, man. So good are you. Almost sounds like the start of Rock With You. Oh yeah, Michael Jackson. Okay, I think we've exhausted that record. Sure there's more, but you never know. Beautiful. So, this is fun, I have to say. Right, I think maybe we should choose something a bit more obscure now. This is actually what I used this morning. So I took a photo with this album. And this is one that I bought many years ago. You might have seen this in my Instagram and Twitter. Called Tokyo Mobile Music One. This is a kind of mini disc player. And I bought this at a record shop. I live in Stoke Newington in London. And Yeah, this is a shop that's no longer there. It's called Totem Records. Mint condition, bought it for £15. Brilliant record, and it's great. It's got again, it's got Yukihiro Takahashi on it, one of his tracks. It's got Akiko Yano, so she was once Ryuichi Sakamoto's partner. She was in YMO for a bit as well, playing keyboards. It's her track. What's interesting about this is it kind of in between the tracks, it's got some field recordings. So yeah, it's, I'm pretty sure that I've sampled it before on things, but you know, this is one of those records when you see it and you just think, well, the cover looks so cool. Just gotta purchase it really. Just now I've got to just figure out which is the first. Oh, there you go, side one. Oops. Cool. Thank you, Funkion. It's great to share. It's great to be doing this. I'm really enjoying these sessions. But this record is dirty. Hey, I've got to clean this record. There we go. So let's have a look. Oh, you know what I didn't do? I didn't do my housekeeping. Housekeeping is really important. Let's just name this. Sorry, I'm just going to go back on Ableton. Here we go. I'm just going to name this. First of all, we're going to color it. Let's go for yellow. Did that work? There we go. And let's just name these just so I know what I'm doing. And we're going to call it Hiroshi Sato. Okay, there we go. Because that's the thing, if I'm going to make these available, then everyone's got to know what the samples are and where they come from. So here we go, let's have a listen to see what's on this. Well, I'm sorry, but we have to have that, don't we? That's just too good. Is that like an aeroplane? Field recordings. This is kind of like the stuff I do for my project, IOTA. Yeah. Beautiful. Which one was it? You talking about this one? This one? It's beautiful, isn't it? Oops. That's beautiful. Oh my god, which one is this? This is okay, it's not that. There's an amazing version of Kraftwerk's model on this, which I'm just gonna have to play later when I get to it. Anyone been to Japan? That sounds like pachinko to me. Let's get a bit of that. Sounds like YMO, doesn't it? Rideen? Except it's not. Nice, that could work. Crazy sounds, I know. Oh my god, here we go. Here we go. It's endless, isn't it? Hang on a minute, did I catch that? I've got to make sure we catch that. Okay. Let's set it going so we make sure we get that crash. This is the album. I looked it up on Discogs. I think it's pretty available. Sounds like Fender Rhodes to me. So funky, and what I'm doing tonight is I'm just kind of record, just making the samples tonight. I'm just going to grab some stuff, and then Sunday I'm going to make a beat. But I'm also going to upload these to the Discord channel so that if anyone else wants to have a go, they can as well. So I'm really just kind of collating at the moment, probably grabbing far too much than I need. Not much. I mean, I've got some kick drums. It'd be nice to have a few more kind of beats, maybe like breaks or something. I don't know if I'm going to be able to find those, but hey, we don't need those. There's certainly some good sounds. I really want to play you the version of Model. Where is it? Oh, it's the second track. Let's have a quick listen to this first one. I've used this. I'd love to make a little house track out of that. Funk house. Kind of ska punk house. Alright. Right, here, let's have a listen to the Model. I just love the fact that the way they've put this album together with all these field recordings and stuff. Name that computer game. I'm Mario. Yes. Here we go. Just got to play this out. Come on, let's enjoy this. Kamakoko's. Okay, I was actually recording that. Didn't really need to do that. Just getting a bit carried away. That's what happens, isn't it? But hey, you know, it's music. This is just such a good record. But we are looking for samples here. Okay, it's too good. I've got some good stuff off that. I know, Japanese craftwork. brilliant. Hey, you know what? I can make my own sample here with some Tibetan bells. But before I do that, let's just do a bit of housekeeping, as ever. So there we go. Let's give that a grey colour, because the cover of this album is quite grey. There we go. And we're going to call it Tokyo Mobile Music. Nice. So yeah, back to the sounds, Tibetan sounds. Except I haven't got my mic. Actually, maybe I can do that. Maybe I can record that in now. Let's just create a new track. And there we go, it's set up. And these are the Tibetan bells. Beautiful. Let's record that in. Maybe you can do something with that as well. Oops. Except I need to record it on that channel. Here we go. Nice. Let's put that back. Let's just have a quick listen to what that sounded like. Not bad. Okay, there we go. Right, let's crack on with the sampling. I think we need to go a little bit more obscure now. Let's see what we've got down here. Okay, so this is weird. I don't know what this is. I've got a feeling this might be some noise music. I think my brother gave me this, or I stole it from him. Tim, thank you. If you're around, thank you very much. So this is Otomo Yoshihide, Sound Factory 1997, and it's solo works, Memory Disorder Volume 3, recorded at A102 Studio in Tokyo, with turntables, mixer, and hard disk recorder. Wow. I have absolutely no idea what this is going to sound like. And the sides are HK and DD. So let's go for DD, shall we? And see if there's anything on this. Who knows what this is going to sound like. So, yeah. All right. Need to clean. Always clean your records. There we go. Let's go back onto Ableton. I had a feeling it was like that. I reckon we can get something from that though. Oh. Some little gems of sounds in there though, the kind of thing that you could just extract, like a little, that'd be quite good as a little snare or something like that. It could be great. We don't want too much of it. Sunday's gonna be fun. I think that the interesting thing is going to be kind of creating some boundaries here, because I've actually got a lot of samples, and I just it's how I kind of, I think maybe I just need to kind of like randomly choose 5 or 6 samples or something and only work with those. So maybe create the pool and then just pick out the ones and see what I can do with that. Oh, here we go. That's absolutely beautiful. Love that. Great. That's like about 50 samples in one go, isn't it? I mean, I'm just happy that this kind of stuff gets pressed to vinyl. It's brilliant. Crazy. I think this is going to be good. Just maybe we'll get some glitchy stuff out of this. Okay. Nice. Bit intense. Not really kind of going to sleep music, is it? Cool, right. Otomo Yoshihide, that was very much appreciated. I've seen some similar type stuff actually at a place called Cafe Otto in Dalston. They have artists that do that kind of stuff, which is always good to see. I just can't wait till venues start opening again. It's really, it's just too much at the moment. So Yoshihide. There we go. Great. And let me just check this is all coming out okay. Cool. this is what I absolutely love about sampling, is the randomness of it all. You know, I'm just literally picking stuff out and then got this, got that, that. 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 All from completely different sound sources. Oh my God, you know what I haven't done? I haven't saved this. How could I not do that? Okay, so let's just save this as sample session. Thanks for sticking with me, everyone. They're still here. Very much appreciated. I'm just going to call this Japanese samples. And while that's happening, I'm going to switch scenes and let's see what else we've got. Okay, I really should pull this out. If only to show off, really. So this is by Ryuichi Sakamoto, and it's the album Illustrated Musical Encyclopedia. And you can see there that he signed it. And this is, I actually met him. I was so happy. I was at Sonar in, when was it, 2018, I think. And I was there with Point Blank. I was doing a deconstruction presentation. And then he was there with Alvinoto the next day doing a talk on the same stage. And I had a backstage pass. And I thought, I've just got to go back and shake his hand and get him to sign something. But I didn't have any vinyl. So I ran around Barcelona trying to find a vinyl record shop, found this and another one, and got him to sign it, which is amazing. But this is super scratched. But yeah, let's see if we can find anything from this. Ryuichi Sakamoto, definitely one of my heroes. Him and Thomas Dolby. That's nice. Oh yeah? Where did you see him, Pixel Chaot? Did you actually meet him? He's a genius. Oh, you saw him at Sonar? Wow. Were you, maybe you were at the same Sonar as me. I think it was 2018. Oops. Ah. There we go. This is it. These are the stabs. I love these stabs. Ah, oh, you were there. Ah, oh, amazing. Pixel Chaot. Fantastic. This is very Steve Reichy, isn't it? Nice just to get maybe just one of those stabs. Okay. Sonar, that'd be so great to go back there. I wonder, I doubt whether it's going to happen this year, is it? Okay, I'm going to say goodbye to Sakamoto for the moment, because I've got too many other ones. Probably going to have to stop quite soon. Maybe I'll do in like another 20 minutes. Because we've already got so many good samples here. I'll show you how many records I've got. But hey, we can always do more sessions. Ryuichi Sakamoto. There we go. Great. So let's choose something else obscure. Would be nice to get something with a beat on it. To say, too many good things here. Okay, now this is good. Let's just switch scenes. So this is an album I bought. I'm gonna have to unpack it. This is an album I bought after I did a radio interview with my friend Tom O'Grady, who's in a group called Revolution 88. He's an amazing Rhodes keyboard player. And I met him after I was in a band with Kirk DeGiorgio's band, actually. And yeah, anyway, he's a massive Herbie Hancock fan, as I am as well. And he recommended me this album here. And it's called Black Pearl. And it's Tatsuya Takahashi and Tokyo Union. And I'm pretty sure that Herbie is actually kind of featured on this album, but there's got to be some good stuff on this. Let's just, there we go. So there's the, here are the liner notes, and Herbie Hancock's there. So he actually appeared on this, which is pretty amazing. Look at these beautiful liner notes. So yeah, let's have a listen to this and see if we can get something kind of funky on this. That would be really cool, wouldn't it? Here we go. And let's go back over here to Ableton, and let's just give this a little save. Always important to save. There we go. We didn't have to look very far, did we, for that? Sounds like block rocking beats. Interesting to see if there's a break in this. This sounds nice. Beautiful. All right, that sounds like it's a hip hop break right there. Let's just listen to that. Hey, Matthew. Oh wow, okay. Amazing. That's a good story. Herbie appears everywhere. Oh man, I love Herbie. So great that he's still around and still doing stuff as well. It's very sad to hear about Chick Corea this week. Sadly passed away. Okay. All amazing stuff. I just want to listen to this, but hey, we're searching for samples, aren't we? Okay. A little bit scratchy. I think I actually ordered this on Discogs and from Japan. Oh, that's good. Nice little stab. Hey, Beats Pacific, thanks for the follow. That's amazing. Love those samples, Rhodes. Kind of good until the sax comes in. Little kick at the end there. It could almost be like an interesting kind of kick, couldn't it? Yeah. When I'm putting this away, I don't know if anyone saw the Ski Sunday I did, where I tried to recreate the Matthew Herbert remix. I actually kind of know Matthew just because we went to the same school, and he amazingly kind of, I think he watched back the stream, and he said, so we're in the actual stream when I was doing it live, I had no idea kind of how he did it, or you know, if he had the stems or what. I assumed that he was given the stems because the vocal seemed so separated. But he wrote back saying that he just made the entire remix just out of the original track, no stems at all. And I'm pretty amazed, you know. I mean, I suppose, you know, it's Matthew Herbert. He's a genius at sampling and doing that kind of thing. But yeah, it really blew me away. I think I was kind of like, I was half there with it. But the fact that I used actual sounds, you know, like synth sounds, I feel now I was cheating a little bit because, you know, he just used the track, which is amazing. Okay, what's Ableton Live doing? It's kind of playing up a little bit. Okay, so let's just name this Black Pearl. I think I'm going to go for one more record before I call it a night. And I can't spell pearl. There we go. And there's only one colour to give that, isn't it? And that's black. There we go. Nice. I'm just going to have to put it back in its plastic cover to keep it nice and clean. When I go record shopping in Japan, every record is in this kind of plastic cover to keep it nice and clean. Beautiful. Right, okay, I was going to bring up all of these now, as this is how many I've got left. And if you can see that. So I've got Tomita, I've got this one, Rainbow Goblins, I've got a concert from 1975, I've got this one, K California Shower by Sado Watanabe. Coaching Moon, Harumi Hosono. Obviously going to be some amazing samples on that. Another Hosono album, Video Game Music. I think it's probably going to have to be that one, to be honest. There's this album here, which Sakamoto produced. I found that in Osaka. There's another Sakamoto album there. This one is by Kazumi and the Gentle Thoughts, by Kazumi Watanabe. Again, this is Souvenir of Japan, Songs, Melodies and Classical. Sumio Kota sadly passed away. He's an amazing ambient musician. This crazy record, I'm not sure even what that is or who that's by. I think it's between that one because I don't know what it is. There's also this Romantic Yokohama as well. So we're going to have to come back for these. Hey, we'll be here all night otherwise. And I've got to go to work tomorrow. So let's have a listen to this one. So this is Osamu. Let's just switch scenes again. Here we go. This is the album, Osamu. Absolutely no idea what this sounds like. Bought it a long time ago. Let's have a guess. I reckon it's quite ambient, new agey. It looks like that from the cover. But hey, this is the beauty of pulling out vinyl. And you bought it a long time ago and you've forgotten what it sounds like. Nice guitar riff. Hey, let's just grab some of that. That's good in itself, isn't it? Maybe some stuff in that. Quite like, I'm more, almost more interested in this guitar stuff that comes in after this. It's a nice kind of guitar riff. That's really nice, isn't it? I'm almost kind of remembering that I might have even sampled some of these before, like this one here. Great sample, isn't it? Okay. Ooh. Love that sound there. Great. Yeah. Love it. Cool. Well, I'm actually quite surprised. Okay. Still not many break beats, but hey, never mind. Let's see what we've got. Cleaning the record. sure how you can classify this as music. Interesting stuff. Lovely. Okay, I'm going to move on and go to the last one now, which is the Harumi Hosono video game music. But that was pretty nice. That was quite surprising. Put this one away. Okay, so that's Osamu. Oh, sorry. excuse me. Osamu, okay. So, Osamu. There we go. And let's give that a bit of a purple colour. And let's go to the last one. And the last one tonight is video game music. There we go. Another one I got in Japan. Produced by Harumi Hosono. I think I saw a little clip of a TV clip when he was actually in the studio doing this by himself. And I just thought it's just too good to pass up. So it's a kind of made on in conjunction with Namco, released on Alpha. Let's give it a little listen. I imagine it's just very kind of, you know, 8-bit. Let's give it a go. Let's give it a clean. Let's switch over here. Okay. There we go. Computer game. Really good, kind of slowed down. Love that. Drum sounds in there. Oh. No. That annoys me when I record over something that I've just recorded. There we go, let's go back. Rein it back in. I suppose this music's quite appropriate for Twitch, isn't it, really? There's some great sounds in there, like this, that, Love that. It'd be nice to have that on its own, but... Great. Right, see if we can clean anymore. Yeah, absolutely. That is just, they're just killer sounds, aren't they? Let's just grab a few more. That's nice. That would sound great through some kind of beautiful reverb. Nice. That almost sounds like a YMO track. Oh, nice. Transients on the sounds are so sharp, so the attack is amazing. Okay, there we go. All right, let's just do the final bit of housekeeping. Great record. I think more than anything, it's so nice to enjoy these records. You know, when you've got a lot of records and they just sit in your racks and they don't get played enough. This is a nice opportunity. So that's the video game music. So let's just quickly name that and then just have a little kind of review of what we've got tonight. And then we can start chopping it up on Sunday. So let's just call this video game music. There we go. And let's give it a nice green color and let's save it. Cool. So let's just have a little flick through. You can see this is everything we've got tonight. Let's just lose that. So we've got maximum real estate here. There we go. Click and fit it all in. So we've got this Ultra Q. Kicks. That's what you want. I think that's definitely a candidate. Hey Matthew, oh, you've been 27 times. Wow, that's probably more than I've been. I first went to Japan in 1990, I think. So yeah, figure that out. But that's yeah, that was with my first band, K Creative, and I actually fell in love with it then. Then didn't go back for a few years until I was in a band called Galliano. And then, yeah, I managed to get back there pretty regularly. And yeah, got some family out there now. And yeah, I've been out pretty much. So yeah, the last year was the first year I hadn't been out for a long time. And not sure if I'm going to be able to get out this year as well. Let's just see what happens. But I really, really can't wait. But yeah, I'm not going to play through everything now. That's what we've got tonight. I'm really glad. It's been so great to kind of share it with everyone. So yeah, I'll figure out what I put onto Discord. If I just put everything in kind of raw, or maybe I'll sort of chop it up and then put it on. I'll have a think about it anyway. But anyway, keep the chat going if you want to sign up. One thing is that if you do sign up to Discord, you need to connect your Twitch for them to be able to sync up, especially for the sub channel. So that's something I learned this week you needed to do. So, but yeah, thanks a lot, everyone. Take it easy. Have a good Friday. We're nearly into Friday already in the UK anyway. And yeah, I'll look forward to catching you on Sunday. Thanks a lot, everyone. See you later. Let's just play out with a bit of music, shall we? グラスを傾け微笑む彼女は素敵なモデル